It is Carl Brown for GuitarLessons365.com. This is officially my favorite filming day in my entire YouTube history. Why? I have Steve Vai's actual guitar in my lap. I have EVO 4 right here in my house. I don't know how this happened. Actually, I do know how it happened, but it's very surreal. I'm honored to be able to play this guitar. Steve played this guitar extensively for 20 years, so he's put a lot of time in, as you can tell, he beat the hell out of it, but it is a fantastic guitar. So I had the opportunity to get this. He auctioned this off a couple of months ago. The person who won the auction happens to be a member of my Guitar Academy, and he flew the guitar out here to Los Angeles so I could film a couple of lessons with it, and I'm very thankful for it. He wants to remain anonymous, rightfully so, but I just wanted to let him know this is the biggest thrill of my life, really. So anyway, I will talk more about this guitar at the end of the video. I'll kind of detail some of the things that Steve has done to it. But right now we're gonna jump into the actual lesson because hopefully some of you guys are here for that too as well. So let's start here. Now, if you're not a member of my academy, like the guy who owns this guitar, please click the link below and check it out. It's all my guitar courses, from complete beginner courses to more advanced courses on technique, improvisation, ear training, theory, guitar tone, you name it. It's all there, and we got a great community over there with some people with some really cool guitars, and I hope you guys see there. Free 7-day trial by clicking that link. All right, so now I am redoing this. I did, for love of God, this video like over 10 years ago. I was, it's amazing how things change. I was sitting in my closet, and I had a $600 guitar in my hand, and now I have a real filming studio with 3 4K cameras all pointed at me, and I'm using actually Steve's guitar, so it's quite a little, I don't know what, there's no words for it. So anyway, let's just get into the lesson here. Now, we have the first main theme that you hear at the beginning of the song. It sounds like this. Thank you. of the big things on this part is there's not a lot of vibrato, next to none at all. That he just wanted the melody to kind of stay on its own here. And he's also on the neck pickup here. So he's got that really... See, I'm not adding any kind of vibrato. So... Now, how do you make this happen? I'm turning the delays off a little bit because I know people hate that. But we're going to start here with the kind of sliding from 7 to 9 there. By the way, I know I have this. This is the Tree of Life inlay. It can confuse some people. The bigger pedals are just basically where the normal fret markers would be on a guitar. So the 12th fret, 15th, 17th, 9th, 7th. So you just kind of, if you see it, I'm calling them out anyway. But, you know, if you're somebody who's, you know, attempting this song, you probably know what fret I'm at anyway, but just like that, I have Steve Vai's guitar in my house. I'm gonna use it to teach. So even if the inlays can be a little confusing. So we're gonna slide on the D string, 7 to 9. Then over to 7 on the G. Now, I think, I see a lot of times when he first started, he's played this a little bit differently throughout the day. In the early days, I think, he'd go up and he'd grab that note, hit the 10th fret there on the B string, and then he's gonna replace it and slide up with the 10 to 12 with the middle finger. So we have this. Now here, he likes to get, he wants this melody to sustain. So what he's doing, when he gets here, he replaces that finger without letting the note stop. He replaces that with his index. So you can do that as long as you keep everything, you push the finger down in the fret before you lift up the one. You'll never hear it. So he does that, he can keep that ringing, and he can reach up because he's got the longest fingers in the world. And do this, which is 17th fret, slide down to 15, then 12 on the B, 12 on the G, then slide 14 to 16 on the G, and then slide 15 down to 10 on the B. So we have this. Place. And kind of repeat that again. Three times he goes back and does that, which is just the 17 slide down to 15, the bar across 12 on the B to the G, a roll at least, then slide 14 to 16, pick it again, slide back down to that 14, and the ending phrase, so that's sliding into the 8th fret on the B, down to 7, then 9, 7 on the G. Pick that and slide back to 9. All right, and then it gets to basically the main theme again, but it's played much differently. It looks like this. It starts at around the 39-second mark of the song. So what he's done here is he switched to his bridge pickup now, and he's adding, instead of sliding, he's doing bends, and he's adding lots of vibrato. Just some super cool stuff. All right, I never get this. It's still my favorite guitar track ever. I have some very historical items from the song, which I'm going to talk about in another video that I acquired in this auction. Anyway, I just love this thing. I could play this all day. So we start here. We're gonna start that same thing, but when you get to the 10, you're gonna bend up all set, and then slowly start adding some vibrato. And then come up here to the 15th fret, bend and release on the B string, then roll the 12 on the B to the G, then bend up the B string, I'm sorry, the B, the 14th fret there on the G string. And then you're gonna play, it's a big stretch. You're gonna pull off 15 to 10. So. Can I start again? So after that same start again, we go back here. So that's a little bit different than the first inning. It's like, so a couple have been in release at the 15th fret there on the B. And then that's gonna be 15 on the B to 12, roll over to 12 on the G. And then same inning. So it is. So that there, at the end there, after you do that pull off, there's a little bit of a bar dive, and then he kind of does a hammer back on the 15 and pull back off. And then we have this. So that's a very specific pinch harmonic that he gets there. So I had to get used to this guitar last night and kind of find where these harmonics were. So that's a bend at the 10th fret there on the B, and then pick it again and release down to 8, and then we're going to bend up the 10th fret again, and on this guitar at least, it's kind of right in the middle of the neck pickup is where that harmonic's at. And then he comes back. So that's kind of the same thing, but here, he picks the 15th fret and slides it down to 10 with some pinch harmonics. And that one's kind of closer over the middle pickup. And then we have the innie. Once again, some very specific pinch harmonics there, which are very tricky to get. So with this. So as it. The same thing. Bend, 15, 12 on the B, to 12 on the G, and then bend into a bend of the 14th fret on the G. And then this is kind of like between the first harmonic, between the middle pickup and the bridge, and then over the middle pickup. A few on that same harmonic over the. And then, same ending. Then we get to, I guess we can just call it the second theme. Now this is back on the neck pickup again. Now this comes in at the 1 minute and 19 second mark. So it sounds like this. We'll be right back. right, so this is a little bit easier. Most of this melody is on just the B string. So it is. So that's kind of sliding into the 17th fret, then down to 10, 12, down to 10, down to 8, then up to 12. Now from the 12, it's a really quick slide down to the 5th fret, and then down to the 3rd fret there. When he comes back to repeat it, as long as your guitar will sustain, I'm just kind of doing those same notes, and I'm doing a little bar dip at the front of each one, and then I go back to this 12th fret, and then here I'm playing. But I think he's playing this, just that part of it right here. Just kind of sliding back and forth between 7 and 9 a couple times. And then back to the same melody. So that's kind of 15, 12, 10, back to 12, and then. So I have a couple of those now, which is 10, 8, 12, a repeat. And then. Very quick slides again. So after that second time you slid to the 12, you're gonna go slide into 15, slide down to 5, and then down to 3, and then back to 5, and then back to 3, and just a slow bar dive. All right, now from there we have this. So that's at the 15th fret there, on the B string. It's kind of a big whole step bend and then release, and then a couple really short ones. Then we have this. So that's a quick little trill between 12 and 13 on the B, then down to 10, then 8. And slide back up, and we're gonna do some double stops here. So that's 13 across the B and the high E, then down to 12, 10, up to 12, down to 8. So you'll hear, like, when you play those together, a lot of distortion, you can hear that overtone, which is, you hear like an octave, sounds like there's an octave beneath it. He's not actually doing that low. It's the overtone you hear. A little bit of bar dive at the end, and then we have this. So that's going to be up at the 17th fret here on the high E string. Kind of a slight little bar dip in return. Gonna go across a D major arpeggio here. 14 on the high E, 15 on the B, and 14 on the G. So 15 on the B, 14 on the G. And slide down to 11, and there's a quick little trill between 11 and 12 again. So this. So we have this. And then we're gonna pull off 14 to 12 on the. D string, and then after that pull off, you're gonna go to the 14 on the A, slide down to the 9th, little trill between 7 and 9, and then it goes kind of slides up to 9 to 10 real quick, and then back. So we have kind of one of those deals when it gets down there. All right, then we have So this right kind of slides into this 19 on the high E, then 17, 15, then 19, 17, 19 on the B, then slide down from 19 to 15 on the B string. And then what he does here is he just kind of lets the note fret out by pulling the bar back there. And not my guitar, so I don't want to do that. So just kind of just go crazy on it. And he's not going to do the same thing twice. It's just kind of one of those kind of random effects where he's just making noise between the transition to the next part. And then we, after that, we get to the main theme, the third time through the main theme. This is at the 1 minute 57 second mark. So it sounds like this. So he's adding a lot more kind of pinch harmonics and really kind of, he's ramping up the drama as we go. It's kind of one of those. So that is kind of the same beginning. You bend up that 10th fret there on the B. That pinch harmonic is right in the middle of this middle pickup for me. Okay, so then back to bend at the 15th fret, pull off to 12, then that's hard to do, especially like me. I don't use a lot of Floyd Rose string systems a lot. It's kind of changing, I think, because I like this, but. When this guitar is gone, I'll probably go back to my Strat. But we basically sort of. Got a bend at the 14th fret, kind of a bend and release, down to 12, and bend at the 14th again, and then grab 15 on the beat, down to this note, the A. It's not easy to do. And anyway, so and then it gets probably one of the trickiest parts of the song where he does this little. So first of all, what's going on here? He plays this much of it and he's gonna catch a, need a little delay to help this kind of sustain. So that's kind of like this, you're touching, you do a touch harmonic. He's basically touching right the string right above the 22nd fret. So that's what he's doing to get that note. But then what he's doing down here is he bends up a whole step and the rest of it, the bar's doing it. So the. And then he releases all of it and then brings it back up a whole step just with the left, the fret hand. And then he does it again, but without the harmonic. All right, so that's what's going on. Very, very awkward to play. From there we have that. This next raise, I'll turn the delay back up. So that's a bend at the 15th fret there on the B. Yeah, kind of review it. So it's a bend at the 15th fret there on the B. Then you're gonna pull, play the 12th fret on the high E string, pull off 15 to 12 on the B, bend the 14 on the G, hit those two 15s on the B and the high E, then release that bend at the 14s. And then you release that bend, pull off to 12, and back into the 14th fret bend. So we have this. From there we have this. All right, so that's a cool little bluesy, chromatic-y type thing. All right, so that's gonna be, so it's gonna play 12th fret there on the B, hammer on 13, pull back off to, back off to the 12th fret, and then do a chromatic line from 15 on the G to 14, 13, 12. And then go back up 14, 15. And then you're gonna pull off 13 to 12 on the B. And then pull off 15 to 14 to 12 on the G. Over to 14 there on the D. And hit that 12th fret a couple times. And then hammer on 14. Back to 12 with some huge vibrato. And then he just taps the, just hammer on the 14th fret there on the G, pull off to the open G, and just do a little bar dive there. So I have this. From there we have this. All right, so that's a bend at the 15th fret there on the B string. That's a hard lick. So you're doing a bend at the 15th, and then you're gonna play 12 on the high E string, pull off 15 to 12 on the B, and then do a quick bend on the B string at the 15th fret again. And then you're gonna grab a pre-bent note at the 14th fret. It's kind of easier if you can cheat it. Kind of play that. Instead of bending here, just play that. I believe he's actually bending up to the note. So we have this. After that bend, you're gonna then catch the 14th fret that's already bent at the 14th fret on the G. Release that bend. 12 on the G, down to 14 on the D. Back to the 12, then. And that's gonna be 14, 12 on the D. Slide 14 down to 12 on the A. All right, then we have this. All right, very, very cool part. So we're gonna slide down to the 10th fret there on the B. Kind of a little pinch harmonic slide. Kind of. So, slide down to 10, and then play 8 on the B. And then it's 9 on the G, back to that 10 on the B, and then back bend. It's awkward because you're bending with your bending up with your index finger. So that kind of lick a couple times. And then. And then that lick, so you do this quick little. Some pinch harmonic slide. You're basically sliding 12 down to 10 three times, but you can catch in a pinch harmonic. Then that same lick again. And then. So that's sliding down into the 8, and then pull off to 7. Then 9, pull off to 7 on the G. Quickly slide from 9 to 7 down on the D, pull off to 5, then pull off 7 to 5 on the A. And then slide back into the ninth fret on the G. So after you're here, you're now gonna get that's seven on the G, then 9-7 on the D. Then when you get to the 9 on the A, slide down to 7, back to down to 5, back to 7, and then slide into that 7. All right, this next section of the song happens at the 2 minute and 38 second mark, and I just kind of call this like kind of theme variations that he's doing. Sounds like this. So we're starting with this bend up here. So it's that bend at the 17th fret on the high E string. Then a bend again. So you kind of do a couple of bends and then release, then down to 15 on the high E. And then we do a step and a half bend at the 19th fret. On the 19th fret there. Pick it, release, down to 17, and then over 20 on the B. All right, and then we have so that goes 20 on the B down to 15, and then hammer back to that 20. You can use your pinky or whatever. And then down to 19. And then 19, 17, slide down to 15. And back up to the 17. Then a little vibrato. Kind of like playing 15 on the B and then. So 15 on the B and then 16 on the G. A little bar dive, come back up. And then 15. Down to 12 on the B. And then kind of a bar dip on that 14 on the G. And then after a little bar dip, because it starts going kind of from 12, 15 on the B, slide 12 to 14 on the high E string, then 15, 17, 19, slide up to 22. All right, from there we have this little quick little pick scrape, and then he has this where he starts digging in right before he gets to the solo. All right, so that's a lot of crazy whammy subs. Bend at the 17th fret on the high E. So I'll just do the notes without the whammy bar first. So we have to. Gonna do the 17th fret, pull off the 15, and then back to 17, and then back to 15, over to 17 on the B. Obviously, a lot of vibrato bar on this. But or whammy bar, but I'm not gonna do it. I'll add that in a second. So over to that 17 on the B, and then a hammer 15 to 17 again, and then again. So just And then it goes 15, 17, 15, over on the B, over to the G string now, 16, 14, 12. And then we're back to... kind of a couple times between 14 and 12. And then it goes 14, 12, 14, 16 at the very end. So this, with the vibrato bar. So I can kind of do a lot of hammer-on from nowhere is what you're gonna be doing. Since your hand's kind of preoccupied with the bar there. All right, that takes us to the solo. So let me, I'm kind of breaking this solo up in a couple different parts here. So part one of the solo, I guess, starts at the 3 minute and 13 second mark, and it sounds like this. So we're gonna start here. We got a lot of, by the way, a lot of wah pedal going on through this. I might talk about that a little bit. I did buy a Bad Horsey wah pedal just for this video. But it's, we're gonna start out with this tremolo pick thing. So we're just kind of picking it across. So let's just get the notes first and you just add the tremolo pick to it. It's as simple as that. So it's 12-14 on the G, then 12-15 on the B, then 12-14-15 on the high E, up to 17, up to 19, 22, then 24, and then you're gonna bend a whole step up to the F sharp there at the very end. And then we get to this crazy solo. So this is where he really adds a lot of... it's not the easiest thing to just jump into here, but... so without the wah, because it covers a lot of sounds, it's very effective, the wah, to how it, you know, kind of conveys the emotion that he wants, but it makes the notes harder to hear. So. Now, getting this thing note for note precise is not the most possible thing, and I don't really think he doesn't really go for it like that. He doesn't try to play it the same way every time. But what he's doing, the licks he's using are pretty consistent. But he's always just kind of like freewheeling it a lot of times when he gets here. So, what he's doing though is you're going to be doing a. So mostly legato lick, and he's kind of taking the pick and raking it across the strings. So first, we can start out with a basic lick, and then we can learn how to do like kind of variations on it. So he has his fingers like he can do it like that. So I'm not doing that. So I'm basically using my pinky on the top note and pulling off 19 to 14. Then 19 to 15 on the B. And then over to 18 on the G. So he's kind of doing like... So what I'm doing there is I'm start like kind of like a hammering on 14 to 19 and then pull back up to 14 and then over to 19 on the B and then back to 14. That's also deceiving because it's two different strings, so they have a little bit different timbres to them, but it's the same note. And then you're gonna pull off 19 to 15. And then we're gonna go. That's kind of the way I'm doing it, at least. So we have this. When you get here, you go descend 19 to 15, and then you go all the way back up. So we have this 18 on the G, 15, hammer back on 19 on the B, and then 14, hammer on 19. So that ascending thing, when I'm doing it as like kind of a downstroke across that, like a little sweep. I'm even doing this one. Now, so you can kind of think of that as the full lick. And he'll do things with it, like he'll kind of play around with just the notes on the B and the high E. And then like every other time he'll add that note on the G string. It's kind of like that. And at the very end when he's doing it over this first arpeggio sequence, he goes to, instead of going 19, 15, 19 on the B, it's 17, 15, 17. So you hear a little of that, just a couple times at the very end before he transitions. Like that. Yeah, the very end, and then. So this is kind of more the same thing, just monster stretch. We have the 19th fret up here up top, pulling off to 13. And it's, but you can kind of look at it the same. Kind of look at it the same lick again. So I'm playing 19, 13 on the high E, 17 to 13 on the B, and then the 16th fret there on the G. So you can continue the same lick. Now, like I said, when you have the wah pedal going with it, it really kind of makes it even more confusing what's going on. So once again, you can mix it up and just hang out in the top two strings, and then add a G. All right, then he comes up here. So he comes up here, he kind of hammers 17 to 20 on the B string, and then 17, 19, 17 on the high E. And it sounds like he's doing that. So he goes like this, hammers 17, 19, then you gotta cut a, I'm sorry, 17, 20 on the B, then hammer 17, 19, pull back off to 17 on the high E string, and then that kind of 20, 17, 20 on the B. Then you go back up, but this time, it's gonna be 17, 22, pull back up 17. So it's basically this lick, like if you're gonna do this lick, but every single time you're gonna replace that top note from 19 to 22, like this. Like that. So if he does that a little bit, like a few times, going back and forth between those top notes, or the only thing that's different, he goes down like kind of, he kind of goes down with his, you can think of it as like, this is a kind of a tune up per string thing, and he's kind of continuing these little trills across. And it's just that 17-20 trill on the B, and 16-19 on the G, and 17-19 on the D. in 17, 19 on the D, I mean the A, and you work your way back up. Same things back up. And then when he gets up top, he has the same lick that he repeats four times. So that right there is gonna be pulling off 22 to 17 on the high E. And then 20, you're gonna play 20, 17 on the B into a whole step bend there, the 20th fret there on the B. So he does it like four times, that lick. And then he starts adding some, he does this. Now, you need kind of a bar that'll flutter. Steve actually has installed in this guitar an Ibanez backstop, which is a device that allows you to keep the, well, it keeps the flutter away so the guitar doesn't flutter as much. So that's an effect that's kind of hard then to get when you have that device installed. And it also helps you, like, when you do, you bend something, bend a note on a, on a floating trim system and how all the other strings go kind of wildly out of tune, it kind of prevents that or improves that quite a bit. So I had that set up in on here, which has, you know, helped me for some things, but things like this, it's kind of hard to get that flutter. But what he's doing is he's bending up on that 20th fret on the B, and then he's hitting a flutter with it. So after he does that lick, just go nuts. There's no rhyme or reason. You don't have to get this stuff note for note. This kind of part, are you kidding me? He's got the wah pedal going crazy. But anyway, that's what's going on. He's bending up on that note and then hitting it with he's hitting his bar backwards and making it flutter. And then he does it again. But Steve has his very own guitar set up, so he can't do that. Anyway, and then we have this next lick. That's one of my favorite licks in the song. So we're gonna start here, the 22nd fret there on the, it's got a 22nd fret on the high E string. Slide down to 17, pull off to 15 and 12. Sorry, just trying to review it myself. A lot of notes in my head right now. So 22nd fret, slide down to 17, pull off to 15. Pull off to 12. Pull off 15 to 12 on the B, and 14-12 on the G. And it goes all the way down to the 14th fret there on the D, and to a bend at the 15th fret there on the B string. And then, after that bend to 15, release that bend, pull off to 12. Pull off 14 to 12 on the G. So release that 14 to 12 on the G, over to 14 on the D again, and then back to that 12 on the G. So I just. And then. So that's slide down to the 9th fret there on the G. Pull off to 7. And then hammer on. You just kind of hammer on from nowhere everything. So you slide down to that 9th fret, pull off to 7. Hammer on the 9 on the D, pull off to 7. Then play 9 on the A. Slide down to 7, pull off to 5. And now we start this kind of like a little chromatic thing where he's really rocking the wah pedal here. But he does it's basically this whole section coming up, which just sounds crazy. It's really just two things repeated, two separate licks repeated. So the first lick that you repeat is this. Then it kind of dissolves into this second lick. So this lick right here, that's gonna start with the 12th fret there on the B, hammer on 13, pull back off to 12, over to 15 on the G, and then back to 12 on the B. And then play 15, 14, 12, and then go back up, 14, 15 on the G. And that's a lick. So you repeat that for a second. It's got that wah pedal going. So after you've done that, like, I don't know, like eight times or something, then it goes into this. Which is playing the 12th fret there. It's really fast. It's just kind of just really rocking the wah pedal, kind of to give it its, the sound is really coming from the wah, but he's just trying to create this little dissonant thing. So it's like 12 on the B to 15 on the G, and then 14 on the G. And then you're bending that note up. And he's rocking the wah. Do that for an hour. And then it goes into the bend at the 15th fret there on the B. All right, and now we get to what I consider this the second part of the solo. Very, very cool stuff. This starts at the 3:57 mark, and it sounds like this. So we got some crazy sweeps and just stuff really moves around a lot here. So it is. So that right there, so it's kind of the same. It's a E minor 7 arpeggio sweep real quick. So it's the 9th fret on the G, 8 on the B, 7 on the high E, and then an upstroke there on the, so it's like sweep across those, so downstroke, and then the 10th fret there on the high E. And then, so that part stays the same, but when he slides into the 10th fret, and then back down to 8. So we're basically going to repeat that lick, but we're going to slide into a new note each time. So we have this. We have that sliding into 10, and then we're going to slide into 12. And it still slides back down to that A. So. And then we're going to slide up to 15. And then up to 17. And this one's a little bit different. You're gonna do the same. You're gonna slide up to 19. And then when you slide back down, you're gonna slide down to the octave of that, the 7th fret there on the B. All right, then he starts going really nuts. So that right there, so you start with the same arpeggio, and then slide it up an octave. So we have this. Slide up to 22, then you're down to 19 here. Then 20 on the B, 21 on the D, but he adds a note, I'm sorry, 21 on the G, and then to the 19 on the D, he adds that note to the descending line. And then he goes back to this 20th fret there. And slides down the octave to the 8. So this. And then repeat that. So that little ending, after he's done this a few times, he does that little ending. and this little ending is a little bit easier. So instead of having to slide down to eight, I'm sorry, it slides down to 15. And then you're gonna play 17, hammer on, 14, then 17, slide down to 10, pull off to 7, 8 on the B, and then 7 on the G. Slide down to 4, pull off to 2, hammer 4 on the D, pull off to 2, and hammer 4 on the A, pull off to 2. So just... All right, so very, very, very cool part. Now from there we have this. Obviously I'm not using the wah pedal for all this stuff because I want you guys to hear the notes what it sounds like without it, but you really need to be riding the wah and accentuating those notes when you're doing it. But when you're down here, it's kind of hard to pick up in the recording, but when he gets to that second fret there, he slides kind of into the fourth fret there on the B and hits an open B and then catches the seventh fret on the high E. When I listen to the recording, I'm like, oh, what was that? I missed that because I never picked it up the first time that I learned it. I was just really trying to get it, retranscribe it this week and just really kind of touch it up. And I was like, whoa, what is that? And then when you watch him play live, he does it every single time live. So he intentionally wants it there. So you hear him go, jumps up and you see his pinky go up there and grab that note. And then he has this. Also probably one of my favorite parts of the solo too. So after you get to this, hit that seventh fret on the high E string, you get into a bend at the, so it's a 10th fret bend on the B string, and then over to 7 on the high E string, then play 10, 8, and then quick little hammer pull, 7 to 8 on the B, then 9, 7 on the G, down to 6, hammer on 7, pull off back off to 6, hammer back on that 7, and then slide into 9. And then he's going to do a bar dip, so you can go into that, you're going to use your middle finger on this note, yeah, on the fifth fret there on the G. And then, so after you kind of let the bar come back up, pull off to 4, then hammer on 7 on the D, pull off 5 and 3, the same thing on the A, same thing on the low E. When you get down to that bottom note, the 3rd fret, slide up to 4, and back down to 3. All right, and then we have this next section. Now this is the only part, a lot of people, because whenever you see Steve play this live, except when he played the first time he played it live, which is in Sevilla, I don't know, is that how you say it? I've been there too, I should know how to say that word. He played a 7 string in that one, and he recorded it on his White Universe guitar. It'd have been great to have this thing here, but that's in Prince's vault. So his estate owns that guitar now, but unfortunately. So you just say I'm playing on a gem, so you think it's fine to play it on a 6 string, but there is one note, especially this one, there's a couple things in it, but this one, it actually, you can see that he's actually using the 7 string guitar. So you really don't need a 7 string to play this song, but that one note you do. So I play the note up an octave, but, so anyway, we're gonna start having here at the bend of the 15th fret on the high string. So that's a bend, pick it again, release, pull off to 12, and then 15 on the B string, then 14 on the G, slide down to 12, pull off to 11. Then 12 on the D string, 12 on the A, and then slide 9 to 7 on the A string. This is awkward because it's not playing on the 6 string guitar. And then 10, 7 on the low E string to the open E, and then it goes down to a D, but you just have to play the octave up of it here. Generally just goes, kind of stops it on the E when I see him play a lot. But it's, you do have the D note there, so if you can play it up an octave, it's right there at the fifth fret on the A string. And then we have the fast run. Oh, it's not the only fast run, but this really rapidly alternate pick thing. You're gonna switch the neck pick up here, and it's just kind of like, so best way to look at this thing, because there's not like a uniform pattern that he's doing, and when you see him play it live, he doesn't have a uniform pattern. Also, when you see it play it live, I don't think he plays it exactly like on the recording position-wise. Because you usually see him starting at the 9th fret. But when I hear it on the album, he kind of starts it like that. He starts it like, just kind of in regular E minor. And then halfway through the run, he kind of into like an E Dorian type thing. So the C's become C sharps. But in the beginning, they're not. All right, but and this is one of those things where you can kind of once again do whatever you want with it. So the pattern you can think about here, you guys know like all your major scale 3 notes per string patterns, that's the one built from the fifth note in the key. So some people call it the Mixolydian form. So it's kind of that he's using, but he moves into like more of a Dorian thing. So what I'm doing here is I start with 10, 12, 14 on the low E and the A. And the first time I play through it, I do 10, 12, 14 on the D as well. So I'm just kind of, and then when I get back to that D string the second time, so I'm not really kind of, I'm kind of working my way up one string and coming back down. And then go all the way up to the D string, come back down to the A. And when you go back up to the D string the second time, you change that note on the D right here to 11, 12, 14 instead of 10. And then it's still 11, 12, 14 on the G, 12, 14, 15 on the B, and the high E. There it is. And then I'm going to kind of end it by going 14, 15, 17. And then 19 on the high E string. So these kind of licks, don't try to just get obsessed about note for note, because it's not going to happen. It's not that type of a lick. It's going to, get there on time, to the 19th fret on the high E string. That's the important thing. And in the middle, just be as aggressive as possible with it and work your way up. And he just gradually works his way up. But when you watch him play live, you're not going to repeat that every single time. It sounds very close to it, but it's just not one of those licks that you're kind of trying to get note for note. It's just more about kind of synchronizing the pick. And when you make it up top, you're back to the main theme reprise, which sounds like this. Thank you. so from there, if you're here, we have this. Now, when I get to that note, I switch back to the bridge pickup. And then we have this. That's a bend and release in the 22nd fret on the high E string. Down to 19 on the high E. Over to 20 on the B. A bend at the 22nd fret on the B string. And then you get a pull off 22 to 15, I'm sorry, 22 to 17. And then a little bar dip there. So it is. And then, so that's sliding into 16 there on the G, 15 on the B, 17 on the high E, into a bend there again, and then back up to the 22nd fret, a couple of bend and releases there. So, got a couple of bend and release there, and then he played the 22nd fret without a bend, down to 19, over to 20 on the B. And then into the bend there again on the 20th fret there on the B string, 22nd fret on the B. And then grab the 22nd fret on the high E string with it. And then pull up with the bar and then do it again. So it's kind of doing a couple of that. All right, and then we go into this. A lot of tricky whammy stuff. So we're starting right, a bend at the 15th fret there on the B string, and then up to the 17th fret there on the B, then play 14, 15 on the high E string, and then slide up to 22. And then pick that again. Then kind of rake across the string. See how I was really heavily muting it. And there's a little bar dip on it. On that 22nd event. And then we're at the 19th fret there on the high E string. Then you're going to slide down from the 20th fret down to 17 on the B string. And then you can pick 17 over to 17 on the high E string. And then he kind of does some crazy on that 17th fret there on the B string, kind of pulling up on the bar, then bar dip, and then bring it back up. So it's kind of weird. So. All right, then we start a series of trills, kind of looks like this. So it's just a trill, you know, between 15 and 17 on high E, and then 12 and 15, then over to that 12 and 15 on the B, and then up to 15 and 17 on the B. All right, and then we're gonna go back to the high E string. Still trilling. Between 15 and 17, and then 17 and 19, and 19 and 22, and then between 22 and 24, and then you play 24 and 22, and then we have this little descending line that takes us into the outro. All right, so that is after that 24, 22, then you pick that a couple times, slide down to 17, then 19, slide down to 15, pick it a couple times. So it's kind of this. So then 17 to 14, 15 to 12. 14 to 10. 12 to 9. And then 10 to 7. All right, and then we get to the 5 minute and 14 second mark, and this is kind of the outro section here. It's just kind of more of a free time thing. So it looks like this. So we have made it to the end here. We're now to this little part here. So that's 7, then 9, slide up to 10, back down to 9, 10 to 12, back to 10, slide up to 14 and 12. So it's, and then you're gonna kind of just climb up the scale. 14, 15, 17, 19, and slide up to 22. All right, and then we had this very little ending. All right, so that's really a lot of wah going on with it. And there's a, he plays it, this is a bend at the 15th fret there on the B string, but it starts with a bar dive, a bar dip first. So kind of swelling with the bar and the bend. And then that's going to be hammer on from 12 to 14 on the high E. Then 15 slide up to 17. Then that's a quick little hammer pull between 15. And 17, slide down to 14, and then back up to 15. And then from 14 down to 12, hammer back down to 14, and then. And that's 12 on the high E, pull off 15 to 12 on the B, and then 14 on the B string. All right, now here he gets some really, really need a wah. So that's just me approximating what's going on. It's just pure chaos, but it's like, I'm just kind of taking the 17th fret down B string and just kind of bending up the bar and coming back down and rocking the wah with it. Just trying to create noise. And then kind of do it again. And then do the 14th fret on the G string. And then back to 70. And it's kind of like that. So it's who knows what's actually going on there. It's just crazy. And then we're gonna end it with something that's easy to hear, a bend at the 19th fret on the high string. And that is it for the love of God. My favorite guitar track changed the course of my life, this song, 100%. I'll tell that more in a story in a video I'm going to shoot next week. But man, how cool is it to be playing this guitar? So for all you guys, you guitar geeks out there, you don't need to be a guitar geek. This is just completely cool. So this is a 2002. Ibanez made this for Steve in 2002, and he's played it for, I guess that's a couple decades. He's used it extensively. There's a lot of war wounds on it here. It's all, the paint's about coming off. It's like a big gash right there. He's got, what's really cool is I've kind of found there's little nicks along the bottom of the fretboard where you could tell his rings, if he has rings. You know, Steve, he puts on a lot of accoutrements when he performs, and you can tell there's like some little, those things are hitting the bottom of the fretboard and causing little dings and stuff. It still has his picks, and he uses this little binder clipped a hold of. So it still has its picks. I'm not going to touch the picks because they don't belong to me, so I don't want to touch them. But obviously he wrote EVO 4. So this is one of only four guitars that has earned the name EVO, according to Steve. And this is EVO 4. This was used mostly for rehearsals and as a backup for his main EVO, the legendary EVO, the original EVO. So on stage, so I'm sure he's at stage time. I mean, you got this thing, he's like, this thing is bent. He's got his custom tape on here that keeps him from the string getting caught on that pickup. He's got his EVO 4, so when it's sitting in the rack behind stage, you can see which one it is. There's a couple other things. It's got his catalog number here on the back. He has all of his guitars. So this is SV28. So this was the 28th one. You can still see this guitar on his website, and it still says he has it in his possession. It's in my house. It's not in his possession anymore. This also has a Velcro thing here. So he did this one that you see him doing like Bad Horsey. And he's got the Velcro. I believe what he's doing is he has a slide with a piece of Velcro on it. So he can quickly go and just place it against this and it'll catch it. So there's a Velcro strip right here for the slide. And what's also very, very cool is he's Velcroed this. So I'll take this off so you guys can see. And I'll probably have better shots in this kind of B-roll for you guys. So this is all Velcroed on so you can access it. And Steve put tissues in here, or his tech did. And that keeps the fluttering down the springs in the back. But you'll see here that these are kind of unique things. These are Ibanez backstops, these couple of things in here. They're actually really hard to get these days because I've been playing my Ibanez a lot and I'd love to have them in it. But of course, not hard for Steve. He probably has them, like hundreds of them. But he has them in all of his guitars. So it's cool. There's like a little serial number thing here. I don't know if it's a serial number. It says SV44. So something Ibanez maybe put in there. It was kind of like they knew it was for Vai. But anyway, very, very cool. I'm going to put this back like it was. But yeah, I mean, it's just when you have like probably my main guitar hero that inspired me to play guitar and get serious about guitar. When you have something in your hands that he played and created on and performed on for many years, it is just surreal. So when this thing came in yesterday, I was just like, when I opened up out of the case and it needed some new strings, but I saved the strings. I had my tech set it up and he was geeking out on it too. He was loving it. Getting to work on this guitar. And we got it set up, plays amazing, has amazing sustain, it's a great guitar. Luckily, the new owner is one who wants it to continue to be played. He doesn't want to just mount it on a wall and just let it sit there. He wants to play it, which is very cool because it's a great guitar. So he let me play it in this video and I'm very welcome. There's another one that I'll also be doing with this guitar. But I thought you guys might like to see the story behind this guitar. Very, very, very cool. Just honored to be able to use it in this video, and I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you're still here, wow, that's a long video. I'll see you guys again soon for guitar lessons365.com.